This mask here is my Phlox mask, and it is inspired by the Phlox flower that they're common around here where I live in Massachusetts. And I'm going to show you a couple of different ways how I've used this, and then I'll do a quick demo. So by a mask, what that means is it's basically the inverse of a stencil. And you can see that here, underneath here, this is a piece of actually wrapping paper, tissue paper that you would use when wrapping a present. I have used an orangey coral color with this mask, and I use this paper to then use as collage paper. And you can see that I used some of it here on this mixed media canvas here. And then the other way that I use this Phlox mask is as a pattern for an underpainting. And if you look closely, you can see that these colors in the background of this daisy here are, it's in the pattern of the Phlox. So what I had done was I painted with these pinks and corals and this aqua color here, turquoise color, and then I did an overpainting with white to create the daisy. So I oftentimes like to use stencils and masks as patterns for an underpainting, and repeat patterns that basically play a background role in either mixed media work that I'm doing or a painting. So I'm going to show you, I'll put these things aside, I'm going to do a quick demo and show you how you would create a pattern using this Phlox mask. Okay, so I've got over here green and white, and the green is the sap green and the white is titanium white. And I have a little makeup sponge, and I'm going to tap some of the darker color, the green, get the extra paint off, and just hold down the mask and start tapping. And that's all there is to it. So by starting on paper that's white and a dark color, it'll be a high contrast. And then what you can do is start to layer on top of that. You could also paint the paper first, start with a colored substrate, and then do the stencils on top. So this is what it would look like if you used white paper. And then let's say you want to keep layering. And this is acrylic paint. It's drying really quickly. This is a summer day when I'm doing this demo. So everything's gonna dry really fast. Now I'm just gonna go right over this with a lighter green. And you'll see how you can just keep layering and layering and layering. And that's what I really love about this Phlox mask. This design here is that it's a lovely pattern to use in a botanical themed piece of artwork. And you can just keep layering it, and it will give the effect of a border planting in a garden. So you know how with English style gardens where there's just layer upon layer of flowers, and this is a great way to get that feeling of a flower garden. Just keep layering, and then you can use these papers for art journals, mixed media wall art, or like I said before, use it as an underpainting for a canvas. Can you see here? This is the Phlox design in the background. So that's how you use the Phlox mask. Have fun with it.